Texas Jack. His tag team partner from the Sudan, weighing 465 pounds, Abdullah the Butcher. Their opponents,
Well, you know, a lot of times in WCW, you don't know what to expect, but with these two, you know exactly what to expect, and it's not going to be pretty. Here they are, Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher, with one thing in mind, and that is Sting.
And the destruction of Sting. These two guys have got to be Sting's worst nightmare come true. And Abdul the Butcher and Cactus Jack, as you said, are two of the most unpredictable men to ever step in the square circle.
So much has been talked about. Even Gorgeous Ole has touched on the boxes involving Sting. And of course, it all goes into trying, I guess, to not only take Sting out, but psych him out in the process. And I feel that Cactus Jack and Abdul the Butcher, we both known Sting for a long time. They represent the biggest challenge to the career of Sting ever. Look at that! 400 plus pounds on the chest. No man can take that.
No strings attached there. Abdul the Butcher is too big to be walking across anybody.
He actually scares everyone. Everyone around at ringside, I'm sure the referees want to say this, but they certainly have to be antsy when Abdul the Butcher is in. Winning matches? Not his motive, gang. It's to hurt somebody. The big guy. Put him right back. Wait a second. We have another box at ringside.
Another surprise, Tony?
Apparently so. Another box at ringside, and the fans are chanting, "We want Sting." There you see it. It's Cactus Jack. And Abdul the Butcher continue to beat up their opponents here this week.
Well, the Butcher's looking at that box.
We've seen everything come out of the box. You heard Gordon Sully talk about on the Wrestling News Network how even more bizarre it's gotten. All of the weight of Abdullah the Butcher. And look at that, he's even communicating with his partner here, Cactus Jack.
You call that communicating?
Apparently it is. Cactus gonna pick him up one more time. Watch out! The elbow drop!
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the team of Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher.
It was nothing but carnage from the word go. Cactus Jack, Abdullah the Butcher, the referee calling for the bell again. They continue their assault. And out they go. The fans are chanting Sting's name, and now Abdullah down at ringside. We still have no idea what's in the box over here. Oh, look, the kendo stick now. When is this going to stop, Magnus?
It's going to stop when somebody gets these two out of World Championship Wrestling, and I don't know who that somebody's going to be, but Sting has definitely got his work cut out for him.
I don't know if anybody can. They continue now. Look at Cactus Jack. You know, to say these two are wild men would really be an understatement. Take a look at the elbow drop of Cactus Jack on the outside that happened a little bit later on.
The damage had already been done, but Cactus Jack flying high off the top there to the floor, no regard for his body or any of his opponents.
And now they are looking and approaching this box. Not so sure what the box holds. And he wants the microphone, just Cactus Jack.
My apologies to the broadcast team up there, but Cactus Jack says he has something to say.
Hey, I'm talking around because this is a party for Sting. But Sting, you're being a pretty rude little man. How are you? Where are you? I hate use this kind of language on television, but Sting you are a party pooper. Hey.
Oh, my goodness.
Doesn't matter where, doesn't matter when, me and my party guests are going to keep going with us. The dance is for you. One day, you're going to have to look into Justice's eye and see an eye, one eye.
Oh, now this is sick. Fans, this is sick. We're going to have to take a break. And we'll be right back. My goodness.
It's your party. Sting, you can cry if you want to. Cry if you want to. Because it's your party. My guys.
Okay, fans, we'll be back after this timeout. This is disgusting.